Good morning. Happy New Year. I know it's March, but, you know, I'm sorry. I've been busy. I've been doing some updates to the YouTube channel. I've got some new websites coming, and I'm all super excited to share all that with you over the coming weeks. But what I wanted to do today is I wanted to show you how to create eye-catching, consistent-looking thumbnails for YouTube. So if you're looking to create better thumbnails for your YouTube channel, then stick around. This is the video just for you. So let's get into it. Right, what we've done on my screen here, as you'll see, this is kind of how my channel looks at the moment. And these videos here, you'll see, they don't have a consistent look. They're kind of just ones where I've taken a still and I've put some text over it. And while you can do this, what I'm going to show you is a really great way on how you can create these thumbnails, and I'll show you them. I'll reveal the thumbnails that we've done. So these are the thumbnails that I've done. I'm really happy with how they've come out. It's got an image of me in there. It clearly shows what the video is about. It shows some excitement, and they have a consistent look, color, and theme around them. So what I want to do is I want to dive into Canva and show you how I've created these videos, or the video thumbnails. So what we've got here, this is a video I've got coming up. If you're watching this in the future, it might already be out. I'll put a link just up here for you. But what I've been doing is I've been creating a consistent look. And by doing that, what I've got is I've got a colour. I've chosen a colour. I really like this kind of minty green kind of looking colour. It's what I have on my websites. For me, it's kind of like a very kind of 60s, 70s kind of vibe. Having been born in the 70s, the latter half of the 70s. I don't know, it's just a colour I kind of like. I find it kind of quite fresh. And as you see, you've got me as an image on there, and we've added these all as extra logos and just an image as well at the background. So what we've done is we go into photos, and I wanted to find an image that said to me social media, because that's what I'm going to be talking about in a video coming up, is social media. So in Canva, in the search bar here, in under photos, we just search for social media. Let's see if this existing one, the same one, comes up. My internet's a little bit slow. Yeah, you can see this is the one that I've chosen. It is a free image. You do have some other images that are pro or that you have to pay for. But just to show you, I'm going to choose a different image. So I'm going to choose this image. And what we do is we'll put it over here, and we can just stretch that out. So we've got an image. We've got an image there. What I need to do next is I need to add some text. So we just go into text here, and we just add some heading text. Oh, it's down there. So small, I couldn't see it. So what we want to do is if we go on this one, and if we change it to, let's say 64, is that going to be enough? No, it's not going to be enough. We choose 88, and then we just type out on here what the video is going to be about. So I'm going to copy the one above. So we've got business, social media, and if we can just drag that in, that kind of business, social media. And we can just drag that up there. And you'll notice that what we can do is we can resize it easy enough. And you'll see the pink bits as they snap. And if we want to choose that, I've gone for a brown color. I've got different colors here that I use. You can save if you go for the pro version of Canva, which I am a subscriber to myself, you can save colours in your profile for different sites and what have you that you work with. So there you go. We've got that. We've got business social media. We can change the spacing of the line height. So we can make that go up a little bit. And if you wanted to, you can choose all sorts of different fonts on there. You can even import your own fonts to the pro version only, I think. Yep, it's got a little crown down here. So you can, if you want to go to a font website or you've got a particular business font that you use, you can just choose to use that font. So, yeah, that's. I'm just going to stick with this one, Oswald. I don't think that's quite the same font as I've used up here. But it's the one that I'm going to use down here. Next thing we want to do is we want to bring me into the background. So what I do is I generally, what I've done in the past is I'll put the camera on the tripod as it is here, and then I'll just do some funny poses. I think on that one you can see me kind of going ooh to the side. So you kind of create a space here, and then what you're doing then is you're capturing your image. So I've done that. So I'm going to go into my uploads, and in my uploads, I think, there you go, you'll see what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually use this one. And you think, well, hang on a minute, that's still got the background in there. But I don't know if you're aware of this. What you can do is you can go to effects in Canva, and when it loads, you can remove the background. So highlight the image, click on remove background, sit back and relax, have some M&Ms. I've eaten them all already. But whilst it's doing that, you'll see in a second, it removes the background. Magic. Simply magic. So none of this Photoshop editing. You can do this all directly within Canva now, which is, to me, it's mind-blowing. And then all you do is you'll see on the side here, you can see, you can just drag that in so it'll crop it in a little bit better. And this will just allow you to resize the image to the size that you want. So I'm going to drag me down there. And then if I did want to, I can add all sorts of effects on there as well. You can see down the side here, any kind of like glitchy effect or anything else like that. But what we can also do is we can add a filter to me. So if I wanted to add a filter, I can make myself look brighter, oranger, whimsical, apparently. All these kinds of things. What you can do if you wanted to, you could export that and play about with it in Photoshop. And you can change the intensity here as well. So, you know, if you kind of wanted it to look a little bit like that, you can see I can kind of stand out a little bit there. What else can we do in here? So, yeah, if you wanted to, if I was facing the wrong way, say I wanted to point to the opposite direction, as long as I've got no text on my shirt, what I can do is I can flip so I can point the opposite way. And that, to me, this is just so much easier than trying to create a thumbnail in Photoshop or anything else like that. But we're going to keep pointing that way. And then what we're going to do next is we're going to go to elements. And because this one's on social media, we can see recently used. I'm going to go to recently used just because they're there. But you can search for all the icons and you just drag them on and put them where you want to put them. You can resize them, you can rotate them a little bit, you can do all sorts. LinkedIn, if you've not thought about using LinkedIn to create your profile or raise your profile, then it's a great opportunity right now as a platform to get involved. LinkedIn and Pinterest. But if you want, you can just put them all on different angles. You can see in the top one here, I like to keep them straight. if that horizon is not straight, I'm not clicking on your thumbnail. Just letting you know. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And then you can just go on here and you can just choose to download the file. So if you click on download, you can choose it as a PNG, a JPEG, if you want to do it as a PDF. You can even create videos and things like that. I'm going to be creating some more tutorials around Canva because I think it's a great platform to use. It's a great platform for helping you create much better content across your social media platform, creating anything from Facebook post images, Instagram images, LinkedIn, YouTube, thumbnails, as you can see. I'll just switch back to my channel now and you'll see this just looks so much better now they have a consistent look. And if we do click on one of my videos, I won't let it play just for now. But you'll see, you know, there you go. It stands out so you can see what's coming up next. So my video comes up next there. And it just so much better. This was last year at Keyframe, where I got to meet Sorrel and some many other creators. This year, Keyframe is going to be held in Brighton. Fingers crossed, the world is reopened in... When is it? When is it happening? July. Early July. I'll put a link down below to when Keyframe's happening. It's just great. You get to meet so many other creators, hang out with people in this field as well. So if you are free in July in Brighton, it'd be great to see you there. However, I want to show you one last trick. So as I say, created this thumbnail and you're thinking, well, that's great. But what happens if I want to now tell people about that video on Facebook or on Instagram or anything else like that? And one of the biggest tips that I can give you is that if you're creating content, if you create an image specifically for that platform, it's more likely, or from my experience, from what I've seen and people I've spoken to in the industry, you get more engagement if you create content specifically for that platform. So if you create an image, you can create the image and put the link down in the first comments. That's generally what happens. So say I wanted to share this image, I want to resize it, and this is with the pro version of Canva, and what I'll do is I'll put a link down below to a 30-day trial for Canva so you can try out these premium features for yourself. If you don't want to take up the premium features, that's fine. That is an affiliate link, but I use this tool all my... that's the first time I've lost my voice now. But this tool, or Canva, is something I use day in, day out for creating images. I just drop things in there, throw things together, and it's done. And what I can do is I can actually click on this resize button, and I'm like, right, well, I need it as a... I want it as a Facebook post, or a Twitter post, but we'll go for Facebook post first. And then what it does is it copies it, resizes it, and then... You know, you just, it's not perfect, but you just go on and just, resize accordingly. So you can just resize that, move me down a little bit. I'll just close that there. Then you can choose to move that up if you wanted to. You just resize it a little bit. If you wanted to move me over a little bit that way, you can do. And that's it. That's your Facebook profile picture, or Facebook profile picture. Sorry, your Facebook post. And it resizes it within, you know, a quick click of a button. Then you just download that, change the name of it here to be Facebook business. So social... I can't spell business. B-U-S-R-I-N-E-S, social. Just call it that. And then you just click download, and it'll download it to your desktop or your downloads folder normally. That's it. But thank you very much. Hope that's been helpful. If you've got any other tips or you'd like me to cover off any other tips, let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. I've got lots more videos coming up around using both Canva, video editing, photography, and some other ways on how you can increase your engagement with social media for your business. But thank you very much, and I'll see you soon.